Yeah, Mr. White. Yes, science.
You two suck at peddling meth, period.
Are we in the meth business? Or the money business?
I'm in the empire business.
I chose a half measure when I should have gone all the way.
You're an insane, degenerate piece of filth, and you deserve to die. Who are you talking to right now? Do you know how much I make a year? I mean, even if I told you, you wouldn't believe it. I am not in danger, Skyler. I am the danger. A guy opens his door and gets shot, and you think that of me? No. I am the one who knocks.
If you don't know who I am, then maybe your best course would be to tread lightly.
Think about it. What comes to your mind when you come across the word Heisenberg? Is it the award-winning physicist or Walter White from Breaking Bad?
Heisenberg.
That's how tremendous an impact the show has had on our collective consciousness.
I'm the man who killed Gus Fring.
Breaking Bad was synonymous with awe-inspiring cinematography, comprising of breathtaking wide-angle shots of Southwest America and indoor shots characterized by dramatic, contrasty lighting. But what really made the show so good was the brilliant writing and pacing, as well as the acting masterclass by the likes of Bryan Cranston, Dean Norris, Bob Odenkirk, Jonathan Banks, and Anna Gunn.
Boy, you need some educating.
Yes, yes, I do. Come
on. Why don't we go up to Santa Fe? We'll make a day of it.
I got plans.
Smoking marijuana, eating Cheetos, and masturbating do not constitute plans in my book.
Who do I look like, Maury Povich? I'm not your marriage counselor.
Netflix just released El Camino, a Breaking Bad movie, this Friday, so we thought it was time to revisit the classic that redefined TV forever. Here is our countdown of the top 7 episodes.
I have to ask, why? Why him?
Because he does what I say.
In 7th place is Date Freight, the 5th episode of the 5th season of Breaking Bad. It kicked off with Walt paying a visit to the recently promoted Hank and manipulating him into leaving the room so that he could plant a bug inside the picture frame on Hank's desk. Next, we find Lydia being threatened by Mike, which finally forces her to reveal intel on a freight train that transports methylamine through New Mexico. What followed was one of the coolest and well-planned heists to be portrayed on the history of television. The trio of Mike, Walt, and Jesse enlisted the help of some Vamonos pest crew, including Todd, to assist them in the heist. Although the arrival of a Good Samaritan and Walt's ruthlessness threatened to jeopardize the plan, they managed to pull it off, but as they were celebrating their success, they turned around to see a young boy on his dirt bike, which prompted Todd to kill him without a second thought. This was the moment which was the ultimate nail in the coffin for Jesse and Walter's partnership.
No! No! No!
Next in the list is Crawl Space, the 11th episode of the 4th season of Breaking Bad. It began with Jesse driving an unconscious Gus and a wounded Mike to a makeshift emergency room after having killed Don Eladio and escaping. It was in this episode that we learned that Gus was planning to hand over the meth lab to Jesse, but he threatens to stop cooking if Walt is harmed.
Don't kill him.
You know that won't work.
Then you've got a problem.
This episode is worth remembering for two things. First, it was in this episode that Gus gave his now famous ultimatum to Walter.
I will kill your wife. I will kill your son. I will kill your infant daughter.
And secondly, the scene for which the episode got its name. When Walt finds Skyler gave more than $500,000 of his money hidden in the crawl space to Ted, he goes temporarily insane in a fit of laughter, one of Bryan Cranston's best moments on Breaking Bad. On the 5th spot, we have Full Measure, the 13th episode of the 3rd season of Breaking Bad. After the gang members are killed by Walter, to save Jesse's life, Walter meets Gus and both apparently come to an arrangement to let bygones be bygones. but eventually Walt realizes that once Gale has mastered the meth cooking procedure, both he and Jesse would be killed off. It's eventful because we get to realize how ruthless Walt can be to survive, and finally orders Jesse to kill Gale, which proves to be the turning point in his life, after which there is no coming back. The fourth place belongs to Say My Name, the seventh episode of the fifth season of Breaking Bad. In the beginning of the episode, Walt negotiates the distribution of his blue meth to Declan, the Phoenix-based competitor to whom Mike and Jesse were going to sell the remaining methylamine. This is the famous scene where Declan acknowledged who he is.
Say my name, Heisenberg. You're goddamn right.
Another reason why this episode makes the cut is Mike's tragic death at the hands of Walter in the end, out of arrogance and anger rather than necessity. As Walt keeps talking and talking, we get one of the most heartbreaking dialogues in the show.
Shut the fuck up, let me die in peace.
Breaking Bad did what Game of Thrones, Dexter, House of Cards, and How I Met Your Mother never could. It delivered the perfect finale. Walt returns to New Mexico to get revenge and get his comeuppance. He starts off by threatening his former business partners, Elliot and Gretchen, and gets them to agree to give his remaining earnings to Walt Jr. and Skyler. He comes to terms with his true self while meeting Skyler, and even manages to poison the treacherous Lydia. In the final showdown, he frees Jesse by taking down Jack and his white supremacist gang, and as he dies alone, surrounded by no one, we couldn't help but feel sorry for him. This is the scene that immortalized the song Baby Blue by Badfinger in the minds and hearts of every Breaking Bad fan.
I did it for me. I liked it. I was good at it. And I was alive.
The penultimate position in our countdown is Face Off, the 13th episode of the 4th season of Breaking Bad. Vince Gilligan has a habit of saving the best for the last, and the 4th season finale had Walt and Hector Salamanca teaming out to take out Gus once and for all. He rigged a bomb to go off when Hector rang his bell, and when Gus came to Hector's nursing home to kill him, he got half of his face blown off when a vengeful Hector detonated the bomb. The greatest moment in the episode is Walt's proclamation to Skyler after Gus's death.
I won.
But the final revelation comes at the end when we learned that Brock wasn't poisoned by ricin. It was Walt all along. And finally, no prizes for guessing, we have Ozymandias, the 14th episode of the 5th season of Breaking Bad, at the top spot. It began with Hank trying to crawl towards his partner's shotgun, but Jack stopping him. Walt pleaded with Jack to let his brother-in-law go, but that proved futile. Again, one of the greatest scenes in Breaking Bad. Out of respect, Todd decided to leave one barrel of cash for Walter, who pointed out Jesse's hiding spot to Jack and his gang out of vengeance.
I watched Jane die. I watched her overdose and choked to death. I could have saved her, but I didn't.
It also featured Walt kidnapping baby Holly, Walter Jr. coming to terms with his father's truth, and Walter carrying out a ruse conversation with his wife to absolve her of blame for his actions. This episode wasn't the end of Breaking Bad, but it was certainly the death of Heisenberg.
You're the smartest guy I ever met, and you're too stupid to see. He made up his mind 10 minutes ago.
I would also like to part with three other honorable mentions. The first one is the pilot episode where the high school chemistry teacher learned that he had lung cancer. Worried about his family's financial security, he got involved in the meth business and enlisted Jesse for his first cook. And as they say, the rest is history. The next one is Phoenix, episode 12 from season 2. This one demonstrates Walter's lack of a moral compass. When Jane Margolis blackmailed Walt to give Jesse his money, Walt let Jane choke to death so she couldn't get in his way anymore. The last one is a bit polarizing. Yes, I'm talking about Fly, episode 10 of season 3. After a day of work, Jesse left, but Walt stayed behind to kill a fly buzzing around in the lab. Apart from great cinematography in the episode, the fly served as a metaphor for Walt's guilt. So I guess that wraps it up. What do you guys think? Did I miss any that you think should be on the list? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Click on the little bell icon to be notified whenever a new one comes out. Don't forget to share this video with your friends. I'll see you guys next time.